Well, just to recap,
the McGrath, Glenn McGrath in the morning.
And everyone's looking forward to another good day for England. For us, another day at the office, I suppose. But Test Match Special is a programme renowned for its characters. Come on, let's go and meet a few.
This is real editing, real.
This is Shilpa, editor-in-chief.
Here's the box.
It's a great shame.
Peter Baxter, producer.
I think
Fred Truman, larger than life. Say good morning, Fred.
Oh, good morning, everyone.
CMJ.
Good morning.
Trevor.
Good morning.
And there over there in the corner, the bearded wonder.
Good morning.
There we are. This is where it all happens.
And it's been happening for the last 40 years, ever since the Edgbaston Test of 1957 when England met the West Indies and Peter May and Colin Cowdrey put on the small matter of 411 runs. Fred Truman on that occasion was practising what he now preaches.
After Trevor Bailey, it will be Christopher Martin Jenkins.
TMS has changed a great deal in recent years. John Arlott bowed out in 1980, and of course we all miss John as terribly. He really set the tone in the box. But as Robert Croft and Mark Elam start the day for England, the class of 97 is settling in.
The weather forecast said there was enough time to beat the Australians
today.
Two fast bowling legends, Fred Truman, and making his debut on TMS, Geoff Thompson. As out in the middle, the first over of the day is bowled by Michael Kasparovic. CMJ's in the chair.
As Kasparovic bowls, that just leaves Croft a bit, but he plays it square out on the offside. The first chair of the day and the first ball of the day. This outfield, despite the rain, very, very quick.
Bill Frindle keeps his eye on the facts and figures, and Fred's memory of past matches is remarkable.
You know that you've got an audience out there. You've got a captive audience. They're in motor cars, probably the housewife, or probably she's in the garden, or probably the farmer doing his tractor, and all these sort of things who are interested in the great game of cricket. And so you have the privilege of telling them what it's all about, the game you love, and being paid for it at the same time, which can't be a bad old life, can it?
It certainly isn't, and our overseas friends keep coming back. The ABC's commentator Neville Oliver was given an unforgettable introduction.
And I remember that Christopher Martin Jenkins, who is a bit scatterbrained, I mean, no matter how you want to paint it up, he can be an absolute twit at times, and he introduced me and he said, look, I've worked with this man in Australia so many times, and it's my pleasure to have the privilege of introduce him to the English audience for the first time, and I'm sure you'll enjoy the work of Nigel Oswald. And it was an absolute gem. Well, instead of sitting down nervous, I in fact sat down roaring with laughter. And isn't it amazing what will break the nerves? And for me, it was a terrific start. And it's frankly got better since.
Trevor, can I just get a thought on how good the England situation is while I hand over to the one and only Aggers?
Who will enjoy this situation as much as I am. 478
Good luck.
It's a tremendously strong position. The ball will swing. They've got a new ball, a lovely little spell before lunch. It's green time.
We try to be a sporting lot on TMS, and this was our champagne moment of the first test, which was nothing short of a triumph for Mark Taylor. Meanwhile, in the commentary box, one of our guests surprised us all when he revealed that he used to listen avidly to the radio as a child in Perth.
In fact, I did a lot and got into trouble over it a fair bit too, because I used to go to bed with a transistor, and my mother found it a few times, and of course, you know, I was banned from certain things because I was listening till sort of 2-3 in the morning. So, you know, I was one of those guys that had the crystal set under his pillow and listened. It was great. I mean, it just really engendered a great feeling listening to cricket being played, you know, like sort of the other side of the world. I guess that's a lot of that actually made me have a great feel for cricket.
Although we're broadcasting live to Australia, you don't have to be on the other side of the world to tune in. One of the great traditions is watching the game and listening to the commentators chatting away at the same time. Some people, it seems, even resort to phoning us at awkward moments.
Caddick in, outside the off stump. No stroke there from Taylor. And, a commentary team, ideally, is a mix of voices and styles. And the cricket lovers have the one or two people, the CMJ, who's absolutely down the middle with the cricket. And then you're a bit of both, and I'm the idiot on the outside. And we're none of us going to please everyone, are we?
And that's it for another day. On the field, Mark Taylor has answered his critics, while, as usual, we've been snowed under by our listeners' generosity.
Radio are so caked out, they're actually giving them to TV.
And we're going to hand you back now from a sunny Edgbaston to the studio. All good stuff, and the lads, no doubt, will be chattering away to you later on. Give us a wave. Thank you very much. Well, we've been chattering away here during the afternoon, and we've been...